Yes, hello viewers. Today we want to focus on another type of ratio. In our previous session, we looked at liquidity ratios, where we saw the working capital ratio, the cash ratio, and the quick asset ratio. Today we want to focus on what we call the profitability ratios. Profitability. Profitability ratios. Every business person who has started up a business, his major aim is to see that the business makes profits. But we are saying you can test whether the business has the ability to make profits using the profitability ratios. You can just compare two items. You know, we say a ratio is a fraction, it's a percentage. When you look at the flow of sales versus what you're spending in buying those items, the cost of sales, when you compare two items, later on you can test. So I want to see the different types of ratios that you can use to test whether the business has the ability to make profits. To start with, we have what we call the gross profit ratio. Gross profit ratio. At times it is called gross profit margin. Gross profit margin. Gross profit margin. Or at times they call it margin. At times they call it margin. So this is one of the ratios that can be used in a business to detest or to test whether the business has the ability to make profits. Now, margin as a ratio, the formula is on two items. It is on sales and the profit, which is gross profit. Remember, gross profit is good from a trading account where you're subtracting selling price minus cost price. Then you get gross profit. So that gross profit is the amount of money, is the excess amount of money you've got from the sales. From the sales, depending on how much money was used to make those sales, which is the cost of sales. So we want to see what's the formula? So we say margin is equal to gross profit over net sales. It could be net sales or sales, depending on what you have, times 100. When you look at that formula there, it is basically already showing you that it is a percentage. It's a percentage of gross profit expressed to sales, or it is gross profit percentage. This is gross profit expressed as a percentage of net sales. Gross profit expressed as a percentage of net sales. So if you have like 25%, and that's what you put as the final answer. So we have 25 out of 100. The 25 is representing gross profit. The 100 is representing net sales. What does that imply or mean? That for every 100 shillings of net sales, you make 25 shillings of gross profit. If there are bags of cement, for every 100 bags of cement sold, 25 bags generate gross profit. 25 bags are gross profit. 25 bags is profit for every 100 bags sold. 25 is profit, which is gross. That's the implication. Already I can compare that. The moment 100 bags have gone like this, I expect 25 shillings back, or 25% of that is going to be my what? My profit. So that's what we call the margin. Remember, I'm comparing two things. I'm comparing the profit, gross profit, and net sales. So that gives me the confidence to devise all possible ways to increase on the sales. Because the more sales I make, the more profit. You got it? Alright. So we have number two. We have what they call a markup. Markup. At times, this could be maybe gross profit markup. If you have written gross profit markup, just know that this is markup. And markup, the difference between margin and markup is that despite the fact that these two are gross profit percentages, margin is on sales, markup is on cost of sales. I repeat that. Margin is on sales, markup is on cost of sales. And do not confuse cost of sales with sales. Cost of sales is like cost of production, how much you put in to make what you're going to sell. You may put in a lot and get little sales. So there are different things. Take time and read about them. So markup is equal to gross profit, gross profit over cost of sales times value. So that is markup. Already we are seeing it is still gross profit. This is gross profit expressed as a percentage of what? Cost of sales. Cost of sales. Just a simple illustration. If you go back to cement that we're looking at, maybe you have 40% is your markup. 40%, that is 40 representing gross profit. 100 representing cost of sales. Now, for every 100 bags of cement, for every 100 bags of cement, you make 40 as gross profit. Remember, 100 are going to be sold. But we are expecting to get 40. We have not yet sold, but we are expecting to sell 100 in terms of value. And then we get 40 shillings. So we shall say, if we calculate it alone, we shall see that get 30% out of 100, shall say for every 100 shillings of cost of sales, 40 shillings is generated as gross profit. For every 100 shillings of cost of sales, 40 shillings is generated as gross profit. So you see that already the ratios are giving us the interpretation, they are giving us the analysis. You can know whether really what you're doing is worth it or not, then you can work out and devise ways of reducing cost of production. Because already we are seeing you're putting in a lot, you're almost getting a half of what you're putting in. So depending on what your desires are and your targets, that will be the interpretation. We want to see another type of ratio under the profitability ratios. This is what we call the net profit ratio. Net profit ratio, that's number three. Net profit ratio. At times they don't call it net profit ratio, they will call it net profit margin. Net profit margin. The moment you see the word margin, net profit margin, just remember sales or net sales. And remember that guiding you here, we are focusing on net profit. Remember, net profit is got after. You get gross profit less operating expenses. The value that you get after there is net profit or net loss. So here they are asking for net profit margin, where you compare the net profit and sales or net sales. So what would be the formula? Remember, it's a percentage or it's a fraction. So, formula would be net profit divided by net sales or sales times 100. To compare the net profit and net sales. By definition, you just say this is net profit expressed as a percentage of net sales. Still, you use the same, if you get maybe 10%, if 10 out of 100, that's what you got, 10%. The 100 is net sales. The 10 shillings is net profit. For every 100 shillings of net sales, shillings 10 is generated as net profit. Shilling 10 is generated as net profit. So that is the net profit what? Ratio. Now, we could have other ratios. Still, they are testing whether the business is making profits or not. We have what we call the rate of return. Rate of return on capital invested. Rate of return on capital invested. Rate of return on capital invested. This one, it is rate. Rate means times. They are not asking for number of times. Now, it is rate times. So, how we are looking at what? We are looking at the number of the interest or excuse me, we are looking at the profit returned to the person who invested in the what? The capital. How much, if I put in 30,000, how much profit will come back to me as a person who invested in 30,000? So basically this would be the formula would be rate of return on capital invested would be net profit over capital invested times 100. Net profit over capital invested times 100. We are looking, so automatically this gives you definition. If you define it, just say this is net profit expressed as a percentage of capital invested. To give you a figure, imagine how you've got 30%. The 30 up is representing net profit. The 100 is representing capital invested. It means that for every 100 shillings of capital invested, 30 shillings is returned back to you as net profit. Let's look at other ratios that also tell us whether the business is doing well or not. That was ratio number 4. Under profitability ratios. Ratio number 5 is rate of return on capital. If it is just rate of return on capital, rate of return on capital, how much profits will I get depending on how much I've invested in the business in form of capital. Not capital invested, because you have different types of capital in a business. So probably this yellow is capital at the start, but this could be the total capital that you've invested in the business. So again, the formula remains the same. Rate of return on capital would be net profit divided by capital. Use what I've given you. Times 100. So if this is capital invested, it will be capital invested. But this is now capital. You're expressing net profit to capital. We would express net profit to capital employed. Now that one is called rate of return on capital employed. Rate of return on capital employed, where you compare net profit and capital employed. We have, remember, there are different types of capital. They can say rate of return on equity, which is capital owned. Rate of return on what? On equity. Rate of return on equity. Equity on network of the business. Still, the formula remains the same. Rate of over equity times 100. You will tell how much profits you will get for the amount of money invested in the form of equity. That's another kind of ratio that gives you the profitability. We have what we call the administration ratio. It also tells you whether this business will do well or not. Administration ratio. Though this one focuses on administration. Imagine you have a shop. It is selling pancakes and daddies. But in a day, they make sales of 10,000. But the administration costs on lunch and breakfast, these people spend 20,000. Will you sustain such a staff in your business? Of course not. They are overusing the amount of money in your business. You make 10,000, they are taking in lunch, transport, airtime, administration costs. They are more than what the business is giving in form of net sales. So when you compare that, you already tell you that there is a high probability that this business may fail or is likely to fail. Those are administration ratio. So we compare that with the administration expenses. So this would be total expenses versus net sales, income got from sales times what? 100. So that one will also tell you whether the business is having the ability to make profits or not. Because all these ones can be used to test the ability of the business, whether it has the ability to make profits or not. Like the last one, we have told you the administration is spending a lot of money compared to how much money they make, maybe in a day, in a month, in a week. They're supposed to, if you make 5,000 from sales, eat 1,000. That is already a discipline. It's a financial discipline. Because you're preparing that the business has to first grow before my expenditure increases. But if your expenditure is high compared to what you're earning, then there's a problem. There's a likelihood that this business will collapse. So that is how you test it. Remember, I'm looking at two items: administration costs, product expenses, versus net sales. Then you compare and see what's the profitability. Don't just look at the stock and then you say, the business is doing great, it has a lot of stock. It may be a lot of stock, but when the money is not there, if money comes and then the administration consumes it. So what do you need to do in such a scenario? That's why it is important to use at least some of these ratios to test the ability of the business to make profits. Thank you so much. Those are the different ratios. In case you have any query, you can send a message on 0708-469247. I remain Central Henry, a teacher of entrepreneurship. We have been looking at profitability ratios. Do not forget margin and markup. Margin is on sales, markup is on cost of sales, though the two are gross profit percentages. Thank you so much.